please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Between 24 and 25, as Sensex is up about 112.
Once the earnings actually catch up, you will find a normalization of the PE ratio over the last 15-year average.
Those who depend on wages, which is the poorer people in rural India, there the wage rate seems to have risen even in real terms over the last 1 year.
Government should give more allocation, more schemes, where maximum people in rural India can be involved.
This will be part of the government of India's total debt, but it's not going to impact the fiscal deficit because these are going to be offline. So 80,000 crores worth of first tranche PSB recap bonds.
The market is up 30 points. It's a good looking screen. It was not so a little earlier in the day, but it is now.
Most parts of the market, barring you can say autos, which took a bit of a breather, almost everything else has done really, really well today. Metals led the charge from the front.
Well, markets rallied for the first time in 2018. Bulls claw back as the Nifty reclaims 10,500. Sensex gains over 170 points. Mid-caps outperform.
The government seeks Parliament's approval for infusing 80,000 crore rupees into debt-ridden public sector banks through recapitalization bonds. Banks have their hands tied as these bonds cannot be traded or used to maintain the statutory liquidity ratio.
After strong core sector growth and robust manufacturing PMI data, proxy economy stocks saw an upturn. Steel and capital goods stocks rallied in trade today.
Demand in Uttar Pradesh is going through the roof, says Ashok Leyland. The company is bullish on commercial vehicle demand after reporting its highest ever monthly sales number in December.
27 days to go, budget wish list continues to get longer. Amul seeks animal husbandry to be given the same status as agriculture. ITC wants tax ops for food processing industry. BSC Tillers wants direct benefit transfer to be tweaked for fund flows to get faster. Well, those were the top five headlines from the day's trading action. Hello and welcome to Markets Today Talkback, the show where we tell you all about 8 hours of trading in just five headlines. I'm Lata Venkatesh, with me, my colleague Prashant Nair. Hi, Prashant.
Lata, hi. Thanks for that. Over the next 30 minutes, as you said, we will discuss the top five market headlines and our experts will answer your stock questions. Joining us now to answer all your questions are Angel Broking's Mayuresh Joshi and technical expert Ashwini Gujral. Gentlemen, thanks very much for being with us here on the show. But before we come to our guests and start taking those questions, let's just wrap up the day in terms of trade. It was a dull-looking screen for the first couple of hours, and then it just took off.
The first half a day looked very much like the first 2 days of the week, when Asia was doing reasonably well, but we were not firing along. Today, Asia continued to fire for the second consecutive day for them, and so did Wall Street overnight. And finally, those tailwinds helped India as well. It's quite possible that there were some early of the start of the year allocations that have probably come from FIIs, because if you remember, on Monday and Tuesday, we did get positive FII numbers, albeit very small numbers. So it's possible that those allocations came in a little bit, because the nature of the stocks that moved are not trader stocks. It was the big L&Ts and Tata Steels and ONGCs that were firing today. As well, of course, you know, the growth numbers finally perhaps reflected in investor interest, the FII interest probably, or even domestic interest. The fact that PMI in core sector and commercial vehicle sales are good maybe hit home finally. And most importantly, in the second half of the day, the PSU cap recapitalization news fired up the broad market, which means more money is going to be hopefully lent by these PSU banks. They led the rally, but they were not the only ones at all who rallied, as you know. Tell us some more details about the stocks that
rallied. So, I mean, PSU banks was the top gainer when the news came, and we broke the news first that the announcement is likely today. But then, I mean, by close, the metal index was the top gainer. I mean, it had overtaken the PSU bank rally. And metals, by the way, have had it good this year so far. I mean, basically the first week, but so far so good. Mm. PSU banks 2.7% higher. The pharmaceutical index was up 1.25%. By the way, the pharma index also came in to limelight towards the end of the session. Otherwise, it was infrastructure as a pack which was doing well. Stocks, I mean, the PSU bank stocks, so Bank of Baroda, look at Punjab National Bank, and then look at something like an IDBI bank. You know, 8.25% higher on that one. But between 3% and 6% gains across the board of the PSU banking's pack. In terms of large gainers, Asian Paints, Grasim, Tata Steel, you also need to mention something like L&T. L&T is again having a good run. ONGC, Dr. Reddy's from the pharma pack that I was mentioning did very well as well. You look at the broader space and just a sampling of what went on. Arcom and the ADAG stocks, which were all beaten up over the last couple of days, came back a little bit. Arcom was the strongest, up 9%. Jindal Steel and Power was up about 11.5%. And you had something like a Jain Irrigation, which was up about 6% or so.
All right. Well, I think we're going to get Ashwini in a minute. Okay, Ashwini has reached, waded through thick traffic, I believe. Thank you very much, Ashwini. But that's the obvious question. We have ended hugging 10,500. Does it look like now we can take on the upper end of the trading band and cross 10,550? Is long the way to go tomorrow?
See, the point is that if global markets keep on rising, while we may have our own issues, we cannot stay down. We can underperform, but finally we'll go in the same direction. Now we can construct reasons around that, etc. But the fact is that last 2 days were narrow range, and today we sort of broke out. Although that breakout will get confirmed only tomorrow, once we can decisively open beyond 10,550 and then move on from there. But it's clear that global markets are still in a mood for a bit of a melt up, a final flourish, as they call it. And we could have our own flourish going right up to 11,000.
Okay,
so that's essentially just setting up the stage as far as the market is concerned. Let's now get on with our second headline. The government has sought Parliament's approval for infusing 80,000 crore rupees into debt-ridden public sector banks through recapitalization bonds. The banks have their hands tied as these bonds cannot be traded or used to maintain the SLR ratio. PSU banks rose on the back of this news. Let's just quickly understand, Lata, what this would mean. And we still don't know the crucial details. I mean, we know some, but we don't know most.
Yeah, so we are making an educated guess, as it were, or the market is. So let's look at people who need capital most. Mm. Remember, rules require that you should have minimum tier 1 capital of 8%. RBI insists on 9%. So who is a distance away from it? Central Bank 7.04, UCO 7.3, IOB 7.8, OBC. That list will come up for you, Corporation Bank. The next list is United Bank, Union, Andhra. So why is it that an IDBI rose first? Because they are the guys who need the capital are likely to rise first. And therefore, you saw many of these banks rising. Okay, I put in IDBI also because they are the guys with more GNPAs, gross NPAs. So the market is guessing that first you will give banks who need most so that everyone is able to continue to do business. Mm. And then you will know who are the performers according to the government and who will get more capital. Mm. But of course, the interest of the market, at least the bond market, is in knowing how the bond is going to be structured. What is the interest rate? What is the tenure? Is it a callable bond? What is the, is it a 5-year, 10-year, 15-year? You know, there are a whole host of things. Our information is that it will be non-SLR and non-tradable, which is a very big relief for the bond market. So that is what we will watch out for. For the stock markets, we will watch out for allocation, as you said.
Okay, we have a caller actually, and we have a couple of questions coming our way on PSU Bank, so let's take them. Keshav B is calling us from Gujarat, and he's got a question on PNB, Punjab National Bank. Keshav, thanks for calling in. Can you tell us your question?
My question is, sir, 120 share liye hue hai, 189 ke rate pe, aur medium term ke liye hue hai. To kya expect kar sakte hai? Target achieve ho jayega?
मीडियम टर्म का मतलब क्या होता है आपके 6 महीने के लिए लिए हैं आप
नहीं नहीं सर मैं नहीं मैडम 1 ईयर के लिए
अच्छा ओके
सो रीजनेबली लॉन्ग मीडियम मीडियम टर्म इन दैट सेंस सो द स्टॉक टुडे क्लोज्ड ऑफ एट अबाउट 178 और केशव ने 189 में लिए हैं 120 शेयर्स अश्विनी व्हाट वुड यू टेल हिम
You know, it's had such rallies, probably on the 18th of December as well. But it's tough to say he'll make great amounts of money even in 6 months. These guys have to start lending, etc. And, the money has to come. It takes a bit of time. It'll take probably longer than 6 months, maybe 1 year, 1.5 years. he'll be able to get maybe 225, 230. But again, similar pitfalls like the ones they had earlier are always possible. But I think in the next 1.5 years, most of these PSU banks will be at least 25% higher.
So, ek saal mein 25 taka upar jane ka sambhavna hai. Mayuresh, what would you advise him? He can hold for a year.
Afternoon, Lata. I'll take the liberty of answering this in Hindi. Keshav ji, mere hisab se, I think, jaise Ashwini bhi bata rahe the, I think I've got a very similar target. Jo dikkatein, I think, a bank ne face ki hai GNPS ko leke, kahin na ki ek stability dikh rahi hai, 11.2% ke aaspaas, ye ratio stabilize hote dekh raha hai. Aur kahin na ki jo aap dekhte hain, jo aging related provisions hote hain, jo standard assets aur jo restructure karte hain, iske wajah se, I think, inki jo provisioning hai, wo thodi higher side pe rahegi, jiska matlab ye bhi banta hai, क्रेडिट कॉस्ट थोड़ी एलिवेटेड रहेंगे बट ओवर द नेक्स्ट फ्यू क्वार्टर्स और जैसे हम रिकैपिटलाइजेशन की पूरी स्टोरी सुन रहे हैं और हमने ये देखा नहीं अब तक कि स्ट्रक्चर कैसे होगा जैसे लता मैडम बोल रही थी कहीं ना कहीं आई थिंक इट शुड बी पॉजिटिव एंड अक्रिएटिव क्योंकि पंजाब नेशनल बैंक डायरली नीड्स दैट अमाउंट ऑफ कैपिटल जो रेजिंग के हिसाब से आई थिंक विल ऑल्सो बी वैल्यू अक्रिएटिव तो मेरे ख्याल से आई थिंक थोड़ा पेशेंस रखें थोड़ा एलोंगेट कर लिए टाइम होराइजन 12 से 15 महीने के बीच में आई थिंक आई एम लुकिंग एट अ टारगेट ऑफ एनीवेयर बिटवीन 210-215 ऑन पंजाब नेशनल बैंक
अच्छा तो दोनों ही एक्सपर्ट्स का मानना है कि केशव जी अगर आप निवेश में बने रहेंगे तो आपको ज़्यादा पैसे मिलने का ज़्यादा प्रॉफिट मिलने की संभावना है देयर इज अनदर क्वेश्चन कमिंग इन ऑन अ पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक डीवी हैज़ ट्वीटेड दैट ही हैज़ 500 शेयर्स ऑफ आंध्रा बैंक विच ही बॉट एट 65 रुपीज वॉन्ट्स टू नो इफ ही शुड होल्ड द स्टॉक सेल एवरेज आउट नॉट गिवन अस अ टाइम लिमिट बट लेट अस गो विद वन ईयर अश्विनी
Again, this is like a third rung PSU bank, but again, totally dead and beaten up. If PSU banks do recover, say 25%, in a good market, sometimes you get 85-90 on Andhra Bank. But, it's always useful to increase the quality of your stock. This is basically the absolute last category of banks that is there. So maybe move to a higher category bank like SBI or PNB, BOB, etc. This will find it tough going on the upside.
All right, that's banks and PSU banks for you today. The third headline now, after a strong core and PMI data, proxy economy stocks, economy-facing stocks saw an uptrend. Steel and capital goods companies have been doing really well. Stocks like that of Tata Steel, JSPL and Jindal Steel rose in trade today, so much so that the metal index, as we told you earlier, was one of the top gainers of the day.
Okay, so we're getting questions on these kinds of stocks, steel and capital goods. Mani Kishore has tweeted that he has shares of JSW Steel. He has 10,000 shares bought at 211 rupees a share, wants to know if you should hold them or sell. Well, this looks like it's a near-term question. 10,000 shares.
8 is the close, so he's making a fair bit of money.
Tons of money. Ashwini, assuming that it's a within a one-year question, should he hold?
See, I see no reason to sell. Yes, metals could be in their final phase of frenzy, but that frenzy does not seem to have ended. And the next target here could be closer to, 320. So now with a stop, say, around 260, he can easily have a ride till 320.
You like JSW Steel as well, Mayuresh?
Yes, I've always been maintaining, Lata, that at least the next two quarters, I think steel companies will keep on doing well. And as a proportion, the value-added products, which were around 35-odd% in FY17, those are expected to inch up. So the kind of impact that we saw because of input cost inflation and EBITDA per ton in the quarter gone by, that should probably start dissipating a little bit because I think the pass-through will start happening. And though we've probably seen price hikes happen over the past few weeks, you're probably going to see realizations improve. So the EBITDA per ton for JSW Steel should improve. And with expectations of new capacities, I think that is also going to create some amount of buoyancy because domestic demand remains extremely strong. The gross debt at 42,000 probably is well within their limits. So to that extent, yes, I think for the next two quarters, my hope is that the financials should keep on performing for these steel counters. So yes, it's a clear hold, but you should take it quarter by quarter.
Okay, that's steel. Let's another question on economy facing capital goods. Twitter user Kamal Parikh wants a view on Siemens. He's got 4,400 shares of Siemens bought at 1248 rupees. He's looking at a 3-month time horizon, and he wants a view for the next 3 months. 400 shares at 1248, stock left off at about 1275 today. Short term, so Ashwini, what would you tell him?
See, the second phase of the bull market will have all these investment plays which will come back into flavor. Now, this is not exactly an outperformer, but we would need this to get past 1480, 1500. And then maybe, you'll see more traction. I think much better stocks are, Sadbhav or Simplex Infra, if you want to be in infrastructure. Even L&T is outperforming Siemens right now. So my sense is they are better stocks.
Okay, fair enough. If he's listening, he has a recommendation to switch over here.
In answering your questions, our experts are with us to help us do that. To the fourth headline now of the day, demand in Uttar Pradesh is going through the roof. That's the word coming in from the management of Ashok Leyland, who we spoke with earlier in the day. The company is bullish on commercial vehicle demand after reporting its highest ever monthly sales in the month of December. Let's actually listen in to that soundbite that we got earlier.
The general economic activity in the country has been far, far better than what it was in the same period last year. So, in states like UP, the demand is actually going through the roof. People have found out that it makes sense to move. The fleet operators, for them, it makes sense to move to the higher tonnage of vehicles. So if you look at it over the last 4 or 5 years, the tonnage has actually moved from somewhere around mid-20, 25s to 31 tonners, to 37 tonners, to 41 tonners. Now we are talking about 49 tonners. Makes a lot of sense for operators to move to the higher tonnage vehicles because of the total cost of operations. So I think it's a confluence of factors. I would still say that Q4 looks reasonably good.
Okay, Ashok Leyland has already moved a goodish bit in anticipation of this great December numbers. But somebody has tweeted a question on that. This is Sujin Surendran. He's bought 1,000 shares of Ashok Leyland a few years back. Guess what? At a cost of 17 rupees a share. That's what you call a long-term investor. He wants to know if he should hold or sell at the current juncture. What would you say, Mayuresh?
I think similar level that what I bought a few years back, Lata, I'm still holding on to my fund. So that's a very clear disclaimer. What the management has probably told us, I think very, very encouraging. And when you're probably looking at higher tonnage vehicles actually doing well or expected to do well, I think there is effects on two counts. A, I think the margins are very well protected. And at the same time, I think with burgeoning demand expected to come through, the discount level actually start going down. So with market share that Ashok Leyland probably has, both in terms of the commercial and the passenger vehicle MHCV segment, it is expected that the volume growth should be quite significant and they should be able to hold on to their margins. The third leg of their argument also becomes the LCV part, which in my opinion over the next few quarters should do well. And on a consolidated basis, I think this should add to the earnings of the company. So yes, I maintain a positive view with the disclaimer that I've given. Please hold on to the stock. I think the stock can do well over the next 1-2 years.
Fair enough. We have another question, and this is Mr. M. Sharma, who sent us a question on Amtek Auto via an SMS. He has 600 shares. He's purchased them at 30 rupees each. He's been holding the stock since the last 1.5 years, and he basically wants to know what he should be doing, Amtek Auto from here. Ashwini, you want to take this first?
In these sort of stocks, it all depends on what sort of value they finally get, because otherwise it's going to be very difficult to make money. So now that he has it, it's a 30 rupee type option. If some great value is discovered, maybe it gets to 50-55. Otherwise, the stock will have a problem, and he should be ready to lose at least half of its value, because you can't evaluate it from a normal perspective, because it's under, I think, NCLT, etc. So he needs to wait it out, and possibly he could get lucky and maybe find 55, 60.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Actually, that's a tough nut to crack. A lot of Amtec, Auto and Metalist, Castex have their projects in say, various JVs, and so the NCLT guys are having a problem trying to resolve this. So as Ashwini says, you have to get lucky. With that, let's get to the last headline of the day. 27 days to go, budget wish list is getting longer. Amul, or rather Gujarat Milk Marketing Federation, wants animal husbandry to be given the same status as agriculture. Another demand came from VST tillers who want the direct benefit transfer to be tweaked in such a way that the fund flows faster and companies don't have to incur a working capital cost. We'll just listen to the management. We are back in a jiffy.
I think our past experience has been that what we need to receive from the government insofar as subsidy is concerned gets terribly prolonged. Certainly cash flow becomes an issue. Therefore, if a methodology can be devised that it is mandatory that the government releases this within a certain specific frame of mind, time space, it'll be good.
You see, what we want is government to allow, give, like we are giving priority sector benefit to the cultivation or to the agriculture, dairy or animal husbandry should be included in the priority sector. When you give crop loan or interest subvention to the agriculturists, it should be given to the dairy farmer also. There is no income tax on agriculture income. But in that agriculture income, animal husbandry is not included. So small farmer is liable to pay income tax, big farmer is not liable. So what we expect, animal husbandry should be treated at least at par with the agriculture.
Okay, let's take a question now. Twitter user Shyam Karani wants to buy Emami. So he's sure he wants to buy Emami. He wants to know whether this is the right price to actually do that. He also wants advice on which are the other FMCG stocks that he could actually look at right now.
I think it's a rural demand kind rural of demand, yeah. question that he's asking.
Budget.
Yeah.
Ashwini, what would you tell him? Emami and any other FMCG stocks that you would recommend?
See, FMCG stocks have had a great run over this last year. Even Hindustan Lever has gone up from 800 to 1400. So very difficult to say what he should buy. But things like, you know, Marico or, you know, Aarti Industries, Dabur, even I think consumer stocks like, Voltas, etc., which are FMCG in this country since so many people still need to get up there. I would, probably do the white goods stocks like Whirlpool, or Hitachi Home, even IFB Industries. So that's an entire rural play, FMCG plus consumer discretionary that he should look at. But as of today, the valuations are fairly high, and maybe some sort of knee-jerk reaction like on GST or Demon, etc., if it happens, only then you get good entry points. To buy at 1400 on Hindustan Unilever and expect 2000, that may not come for a while.
Fair point. When you buy expensive stocks, you have to wait longer to make money. Ashwini and Mayuresh, thank you very much for patiently answering questions of our viewers. We have to wrap up on this edition of Markets Today Talk Back.